The Premier will carry a $2.3 billion war chest into this year's election. Money set aside in today's state budget. No word on when Victoria will begin paying back its record debt, but the Treasurer has a secretive plan to sell VicRoads. State political reporter Mark Santomartino.
Fittingly, there was no trademark thud as the budget truck arrived at Parliament. Lighter reading for a Treasurer delivering his eighth budget.
We are open and rebuilding.
And banking on VicRoads to dig his state out of debt.
We're returning to surplus while also caring for Victorians.
Selling the right to run Victoria's licence and registration system is hoped to earn the state billions. The deal is yet to be done, but that money will go into a new future fund designed to start paying down the state's record debt, which is forecast to climb to $167 billion in 2026, more than 26% of Victoria's GDP.
I think I'm going to have a good story to tell come July.
In a budget spending big on health, education and infrastructure, an increase in taxes has Victoria's annual deficit shrinking. We'll post a cash surplus for the first time next financial year, but it'll be three more until the state is saving money.
Today's state budget is not a pandemic repair plan. It's a PR repair plan for one Victorian, Daniel Andrews.
Thanks to looming rate rises,
sold.
Victoria is predicted to rake in almost $5 billion in land tax but lose out on stamp duty, with Treasury bracing for a 4% drop in property prices.
We expect to see interest rates continue to rise over the next 12 to 18 months.
There wasn't any money for the MCG's Shane Warne stand, but $2.6 billion will build regional Victoria to host the Commonwealth Games.
We want to make sure that Commonwealth Games athletes' villages are purpose-built to be delivered as social and affordable housing, to leave a lasting legacy.
But the legacy of major projects, not major events, is proving to be the problem, with the Westgate Tunnel headlining another $5.8 billion infrastructure blowout. It alone is now $4.7 billion over budget, COVID costs adding another $800 million to its bottom line.
The government's budget today is built on blowouts and waste that should have been avoided.
$55 million will be spent beefing up anti-corruption surveillance at Crown, which will pay a bigger share of Victoria's $2.3 billion pokies tax. Post-COVID, Victorians will also pay more in fines and more to register our vehicles, money that will fund $780 million in road maintenance, buy 12 new velocity trains and hire 300 people to work on the Metro Tunnel once it opens.
Employment has risen by 280,000 jobs.
Tim Pallas confirming the government's 1.5% wage rise policy will have to change as inflation pushes 5%.
1,900 additional teachers funded in this budget, which is fantastic.
$1.8 billion will be spent on education upgrades, with money to build new primary schools at Clyde North and Officer, Mickleham and Lockerbie in Melbourne's north, and at Brookfield, Truganina North, Tarneit North and Black Forest East. The West will also get three new secondary and two specialist schools. Burwood East Special School is one of 36 that are in for upgrades. $8 million will replace portables for purpose-built buildings for senior students like Joey. Almost $2 million will be spent at Blackburn's Aurora School for kids who are deaf or hard of hearing.
Greatly appreciated by the families and the children.
Since 2015, we've upgraded every special school in the state.
Mark Santomartino, Nine News.
Health is shaping up as the key state election issue, with the budget committing a huge spend. As Heidi Murphy says, patients are being promised better care.
The Premier enlisted one of his own carers.
Today I'm visiting a patient who injured themselves last year.
To start the budget hard sell.
Hello, Julie. Good to see you again. Come in.
The social media post spruiking a $698 million pledge to expand healthcare at home.
You know, having someone who actually comes into the home and reassures you that you're doing the right thing.
All up, $12 billion is being spent on what they're calling
a pandemic repair plan.
The damage bill, a big one. For soaring waiting lists, there's the funds for the promised surgery blitz. To staff the struggling services, 7,000 new or retrained workers, including nurses and paramedics. And for the crisis at 000, $333 million for call takers and equipment.
The pandemic has tested our emergency responses, and every Victorian deserves to know that when they need it, help will come.
So, yes, we need to get 000 right.
Trying to reduce ambulance ramping, trying to find alternative pathways, fixing a lot of the issues with ESTA, with call taking and dispatch. That's really where we'll get the most bang for our bucks.
Other big dollars, $1.1 billion for RATs and $284 million for masks for health workers in the year ahead. There's also $500 million to get Barwon Women's and Children's Hospital off the ground.
And for Melbourne's booming outer west, there is money at last for a hospital that will one day be in this paddock at Cobblebank. No date's been set yet, though, for when patients can expect local care. Design work will take the next 2 to 3 years.
You'd be forgiven for thinking the billion-dollar building isn't far off.
To re-announce hospitals like Melton, for instance, where the money comes toward the end of the forward estimates, is really insulting. They've been waiting for that hospital now for 5 years.
This budget is putting patients first.
Yeah. Heidi Murphy, Nine News.